good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, according to Team Pacquiao, 8 division, legendary, world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao, he is indeed not pursuing a showdown, a massive showdown, with undefeated 3 division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered by most to be the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. With that said, it was reported that Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao seem to be headed to a face-off June 5th. And now, that temperature has since been doused as Team Pacquiao comes out and they said that it's completely not true that the negotiations for themselves and Terrence Crawford is taking place. In fact, they still have former 4-division world champion Mexican superstar boxer Mikey Garcia as their number one objective, is leading the race. Mikey Garcia, 40 wins, 1 loss, 30 wins by way of knockout. He's 33 years of age. The last time we saw Mikey Garcia in the ring was when he took on Jesse Vargas back in February of 2020. Mikey Garcia stands at 5'6" with a 68-inch arm reach. He's very compatible to Manny Pacquiao in size, okay? There's a lot of similarities in size. There's a lot of familiarity with Mikey Garcia because he has resemblance to Manny Pacquiao's longtime rival, 4-division world champion, Mexican superstar, iconic boxer, who's a Hall of Famer, and rival who fought 4 times, Juan Manuel Marquez. They're very, very similar in stature. They're very, very similar in their style. And Manny Pacquiao's very, very familiar with Juan Manuel Marquez, obviously, and that style. I told you guys he would choose Mikey Garcia because of familiarity, okay? Oddly enough, Juan Manuel Marquez is heading into an exhibition showdown June 12th against Miguel Cotto. That's for another story. But Juan Manuel Marquez is now retired. He's retired 56 wins, 7 losses, 1 draw, 40 wins by way of knockout. 3 of those losses, 2 losses came to Manny Pacquiao, and that draw came at the hands of Manny Pacquiao. Juan Manuel Marquez stood at 5'6" with a 67-inch arm reach. Mikey Garcia stands at 5'7" with a 67-inch arm reach. Mikey Garcia stands at 5'6" with a 68-inch arm reach. Their style is very, very similar. Okay, last time Juan Manuel Marquez was in the ring, and it counted, was May of 2014 when he defeated Mike Alvarado via unanimous decision. Okay, so there's a lot of similarities between Juan Manuel Marquez and Mikey Garcia. And you have to understand, the last time they fought, that being Marquez and Manny Pacquiao, Juan Manuel Marquez brutally knocked out Manny Pacquiao. And Manny Pacquiao, at the time, had been vying for a 5th fight with Juan Manuel Marquez, campaigning for that fight because, he wanted his get back. Manny Pacquiao, 62 wins, 7 losses, 2 draws, 39 wins by way of knockout. Three times himself, he was knocked out. He stands at 5'5" with a 67-inch arm reach, okay? He's 42 years of age. And like I said, when he was brutally knocked out by Juan Manuel Marquez, that was back in December of 2012, okay? He from that point, he was campaigning to get a fight, a 5th fight with Juan Manuel Marquez. With Juan Manuel Marquez, he stated he wanted to leave the Manny Pacquiao saga just where it is, okay? So like I said, there was a lot of talk yesterday. It seemed to be heating up between Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao headed to June 5th. And now Manny Pacquiao's team, they have since doused it. And they are stating that, this is the same tactics that legendary promoter, top-ranked CEO and promoter, former promoter Manny Pacquiao and current promoter of Terrence Crawford, this is the same sentiments he uttered in 2020 when he told the world that they had a deal done for November 14th. And the investment group fell through, okay? So maybe this is what Bob Arum is leading Terrence Crawford to believe. Terrence Crawford, 37 wins, 28 no losses, 28 wins by way of knockout. He's 33 years of age, stands at 5'8" with a 74-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was November 14th when he stopped Kell Brook, former IBF welterweight world champion, British superstar boxer, in dramatic fashion in that fight, okay? But that, in Bob Arum's words, was supposed to be Manny Pacquiao in that fight and not Kell Brook. But due to the investment group deciding that they won't get a return on their investment, not having fans in attendance and losing money, that they pulled out. And so they couldn't afford to pay Manny Pacquiao the purse that he was looking for, or the purse that Terrence Crawford was looking for, okay? So they decided that they could not continue and push forward with a fight between them and Manny Pacquiao. So that left Bob Arum scrambling for an opponent, in which he decided to, you know, go with Kell Brook. With that said, you know, now we're going to get, you know, Terrence Crawford scrambling for an opponent once again, as they, you know, have now they're stating that Mikey Garcia still is leading the pack, okay, once again. But just a few weeks ago, Manny Pacquiao and his team, they came out and they said that, you know, Terrence Crawford was still an option, but Mikey Garcia, he was leaning towards fighting Mikey Garcia, which, in my opinion, just didn't add up to me, because Manny Pacquiao was the WBA champion after he defeated former unified WBC, WBA welterweight world champion superstar boxer Keith One Time Thurman, July of 2019, for his WBA title. And then he decided, due to inactivity, obviously, in 2020, you know, there was a lot of inactivity. But for the remainder of 2019, because they fought in July, he didn't fight anymore in 2019. There was possibilities and options for him to fight in the rest of 2019, but he opted not to. Then he fought none of 2020. Now he's heading into 2021. And the WBA stated that you need to fight somebody in the top 10 in the ranking system. And Manny Pacquiao, he had his sights set on a UFC superstar, iconic legend, Conor McGregor. And he's indecisive. There was talks of a possibility him fighting Ryan Garcia. So he's just indecisive, and he's holding up the sport. And the WBA, they just didn't want him to continue to hold up the sport. So they ended up removing him as the WBA champion and elevated Cuban star welterweight, who was the regular WBA champion, Yordanis Ugas, to super champion, the sole WBA welterweight world champion. So with that said, if he's going to lean towards Mikey Garcia, Mikey Garcia is number 4 in the ranking system. So if he was going to lean towards Mikey Garcia the entire time, then he should have announced that, which he would have kept the belt. And in beating Mikey Garcia, it awards him an even bigger payday against Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford if he so choose to fight them in the future in a unification bout. But Manny Pacquiao allowed himself to be, you know, stripped of the WBA title. The other sanctioned bodies wasn't happy that WBA made the swift move to remove him. But inactivity, going on 2 years, not fighting anybody in the top 10 ranking system. So they did the right thing, because he's still indecisive. Okay, so that didn't add up to me. But, you know, we are already in April, and they were saying that this fight was going to take place in June 5th between Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao. Well, that leaves them 2 months. You know, now we know Manny Pacquiao, he started training already. Terrence Crawford is always in shape. So it's not like they need more than 8 weeks to prepare for a showdown. You know, we saw Terrence Crawford, he was, you know, sparring, you know, he's, you know, revving up training camp. He's preparing himself to get back in the ring. And now we obviously know Manny Pacquiao, he stated that he's back in sparring, back in training and revving up his camp. So it made sense that they would fight each other. They don't need more than 8 weeks to prepare for one another, because Manny Pacquiao, he stays in shape. Obviously, there's some ring rust that he's going to have to knock off in sparring, in training camp. But Manny Pacquiao, he also stated he didn't want to go into a fight of this magnitude coming off a 2-year layoff. Well, now, you know, there's a lot of confusion. And now Team Pacquiao is letting it be known that they are still leaning towards Mikey Garcia. Now, Mikey Garcia, at one point in time, he sounded very confident he was going to secure the Manny Pacquiao fight. Since then, Mikey Garcia's tone has slightly changed, and his confidence seemed to have wavered that he's going to secure the Manny Pacquiao fight. And he started to say, well, if the Pacquiao fight happens, you know, that's great. If it doesn't, I'm not going to continue to chase him. Now, we know Terrence Crawford, he's been trying to secure a Manny Pacquiao fight since the better part of 2015, for the better part of 6 years. And he states that's his number one objective, is to secure a Manny Pacquiao fight. Well, Mikey Garcia is no longer, you know, he can take it or leave it. You see undefeated unified WBC IBF welterweight world champion superstar boxer Errol "The Truth" Spence Jr. Ever since Manny Pacquiao was stripped of the belt, Errol Spence has made no mention of Manny Pacquiao. He don't believe that, you know, Manny Pacquiao is interested in fighting him. Manny Pacquiao was ringside at two of his fights, even got in the ring after one of his fights, the Mikey Garcia fight, in which he dominated Mikey Garcia, and he still didn't agree to fight Errol Spence. Errol Spence has since turned his attention to Yordanis Ugas in a unification bout that's being rumored to take place in July. Terrence Crawford's number one objective is Manny Pacquiao. For whatever reason, he just needs to secure that fight. That's his dream fight. So we got to see how this unfolds. But Manny Pacquiao and his team are still saying now that Mikey Garcia is in the running, is leading the pack to get the Manny Pacquiao fight. So let's see how this unfolds. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
Hey, this is Ebony Bridges, Blonde Bomber, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.